doing? This is Ems, and welcome to another episode of Ems UAE Adventures. And what I love doing about this show, it's not just all about the crazy out and about stuff. I love to catch up with people who I find inspirational, interesting, and they have amazing stories to tell. And that's what we're doing in this episode, as well as, you know, doing a little bit of a booty shake as well, because we all like a bit of that. So I'm going to catch up with my guest right now. And so let's introduce you to my guest. Her name is Bemi Giwa, and she used to be known as Dubai Fit Foodie, but that acronym, that name is long gone, Bemi, I think, isn't it?
Yes, it's long gone, but I still feel like a fit foodie.
And the reason I always love to chat with you, you're one of the people that I find most inspiring here in Dubai, because you've come such a long way. You know, you're an entrepreneur, you're a fitty person, you get out there, you do all these amazing things. But let's give a little bit of your backstory. One of the things I love about you, you had a job out of university, you did all your studies and everything, and you were just like, I'm sick of this, and quit doing that to go on and do the things that you love. So just give us a bit of a background on that.
Yes, so I'm one of those millennials who didn't work for too long. I was working, I loved my job, but I just felt that I was called to do more, so I quit. Don't quit. I mean, quit if you have a plan, but definitely I don't regret doing that at all. I've run through a few businesses, and right now I'm currently dancing, and obviously I have my food company as well. So it's been a very kind of challenging journey, but extremely rewarding. Yeah.
But for someone so young to take on all of that, and literally you've followed your dream and done the things that you wanted to do. So what's your inspiration been for doing all of that?
I think for me is, I kind of have this no excuses, and I jump in before I think too much. I think a lot of people are stuck in this phase where, you know, they overthink, or what if I fail, what if it doesn't work out, and people just kind of get stuck in this cycle. But the thing is, if you really have a calling to do something, go for it. Like, you're only going to learn. Like, there are going to be challenges along the way for sure, but at the other side of this is going to be the most beautiful journey like that you could have ever expected, and it's going to be so worth it as long as you're passionate about it and you're making a difference. Yeah.
On the foodie side of things, because I know you launched Catfish, kind of bringing that beautiful African flavors, and oh, I love it, so good. But the whole COVID situation has been really tough on you for that.
Yeah, it definitely has. My restaurants had to temporarily close down, and we're only after now 8 months just planning our reopening. So you can imagine what's happening in those 8 months. It's been a lot of like hair pulling, is it worth reopening? But again, at the other side of, you know, all that fear is this commitment to passion and commitment to serving, and knowing at the end of the day I have a good product and it's something that people want. And with that kind of confidence in me, I am excited for phase two. I can't wait.
Because you were kind of operating out of one of these shared kitchens to begin with, but I know just before everything hit, you were just about to launch your first bricks and mortar outlet. So when are we going to see that? Hopefully, fingers crossed.
So actually, we did open our brick and mortar location, and we've had it for about 4 months before COVID. So you can imagine all the kind of, it was really, really tough financially, of course, to kind of maintain that kind of cash flow. But I think finally, after 8 months, we've kind of been able to weave through. And I'm really excited to be launching a brick and mortar concept for Catfish. It's going to be at the Dubai Police Academy, Rife Market. It is a container that we've repurposed into a restaurant, and it's going to be so cool.
Can I be first in line?
Yes.
Like, give me the food.
I'm booking a table for you, your entire family, your grandma, your auntie, your cousin, your friend. Tell your friend. Tell everybody, okay? I have your space booked. Yeah, I'm really excited.
It's amazing. I can't wait to see it again. And tell me about the health and fitness side of things, because you're one person that's very, very prominent on this in Dubai and the UAE. And you've been cycling this morning in crazy locations, and we're in the middle of Dubai 30-30 at the moment, the Dubai Fitness Challenge, which of course happens every year. And during the COVID times, it was really hard. Lots of people doing classes via Zoom at home and home workouts. How are you finding people getting back into it all now?
I feel like people have been pacing themselves. Definitely, if you've been stuck at home for a while, you know, you're kind of craving this little bit of activity, of excitement. I'm really excited to have partnered with Dubai Fitness Challenge for the third time in a row this year. And I actually have a workout. So if you go on Jumeirah Beach, you can scan the app and then you can see my workout. So people are working out with me from across the world. And I think people are looking for that excitement. Even with our dance classes as well, as soon as the lockdown lifted, we had this kind of huge influx of people who just wanted that connection. They were obviously maintaining social distancing, but dancing together, exercising together, people just want that you know, a reason to move and something that kind of helps them forget that we are still in the middle of a pandemic. Yeah.
And it's one thing I love about you is you have this dance style that you've brought here, which is so different. Tell me why you got into that and why you wanted to bring that specifically here.
Yes, so when I was in uni here, we used to put on yearly shows for called Global Day, and I would always be a part of the Nigerian show. And when I came out of school, I'm like, oh, I really want to do something like this. It's just not happening. So I started doing my Afrofit classes. So Afrofit is a high intensity dance class that mixes HIIT workouts with dance movements. And over time, that's kind of really evolved now. I teach Afro Vibes, which is more tapping into your feminine side, but through dance and through Afro styles. I think the dance is very, very soulful. You know, the music is very in. Yeah. I go out now and I see so many people enjoying Afrobeat, and I'm like, who gave you that playlist, you know? But it's just so mainstream now. So dancing with people, connecting, and really sharing a part of my culture, it makes me so happy. Like when I see people dancing, I'm like, yes, girl, you better work, you better shake. Yeah, yeah, it's so much fun. I just love doing it, yeah.
I'm watching you do it with the routines and the choreography. Mm-hmm. It's not just a physical workout, mm-hmm. because for someone like me who's completely uncoordinated, you know this. it challenges your brain as well.
Yes, yes. It really, really does. I feel like dance or physical exercise in general, that forces you to kind of like work in rhythm. It just, you give into your body, you know, you're not really, it challenges your brain, but like over time you just have this flow and it connects the dots. And I think you take that out of the class as well, because in that moment you're just in the rhythm, you're in the movement. Of course, as a beginner, it's a bit different because you're more self-conscious, but the moment you kind of let go and allow yourself to just be, it becomes quite enjoyable. Yeah.
Well, I think we've chatted for a while now, yeah. So I think we need to, first of all, I want you to show me a few of the moves, okay. And then I'm just going to get you to do your thing and show us the whole choreo. Yeah. How does that sound?
It sounds freaking amazing. I can't wait to dance with you.
You know, I'm terrible at it. This is completely uncoordinated.
This is
not going to go well. I'm a little bit hot and sweaty now. It's a lot harder than it looks. You girls make it look so easy. And you brought in Eva here, who is your co-founder of Dance Body. Hello, how are you doing?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
Good. So tell me, what's your story? How did you get involved in all of this?
All right, so it's actually a funny story how Bemi and I met. So I was looking to do a Beyonce masterclass in Dubai. I used to teach in London and I moved to Dubai, and I was looking to do a Beyonce masterclass, but I don't have those Afro moves that certain someone does. So I picked up a newspaper, picked up a magazine, and actually like I found Bemi there, but it was more like a fitness section. So fitness and food. So I was like, I was wondering if she dances, right? So I went on her Instagram and I was like, oh yeah, this girl does dance, right? So I was like, let me get in touch. And then I got in touch, we met, we clicked straight away. And then the following day, Bemi asked me, she called me, and she was like, hey, how about we do a 30-day dance challenge? I'm like, okay. And we didn't have a venue, we didn't have, you know, people to join it, but we actually sold it out. So that's how it started. And then we're like, you know what, we have something really good here. So then we continued teaching, and then we set up Dance Body DXB. Yeah. And you know, now we're teaching at Studio Republic, we have regular classes, so we're very happy. We're very happy to have a really good community of women coming to our classes.
And you literally, adding to your entrepreneurial ship, you just dropped on me that you've designed and you're launching this beautiful fitness wear. Tell me about that, because this is stunning. I need all of this.
So definitely, with our Dance Body, one of the things that we stand for is empowering women, and that goes in the class and outside of class, and also how you feel in clothes. So we've been working on this kind of clothing line that we want to kind of release next year, and we've been working actually with our students, so they're co-designing it for us, and that way we really hope that, you know, everyone kind of feel represented in the clothes and the choices that we make. And I think just setting us as ourselves as a company, yes, we do dance, and that's the foundation of what we do, because that's how we connect with other women, but we do other things, and this is really what we represent at Dance Body DXB.
That's amazing, and I love the fact that you're getting feedback. So what, during the feedback from your students, what were the things that women were unhappy with the current sportswear?
With the current sportswear, I think, you know, it's a bit difficult to find something that fits everybody, right? So what we are looking for is making people feel comfortable with whatever we're going to go with, right? So the clothing line that we're thinking about is just something that fits everybody, right? Because we want to be inclusive. Mm-hmm.
And I'll tell you my biggest bugbear is sports bras that zip up the front. That's what I need for us, let's say top weighty girls. We need the front zips in there.
Yeah, idea. You're back and you're like, yeah, okay. We'll work on it. Okay. Yes.
So when can we see you launching these?
I think for us would be definitely in March. The first thing that we're launching next year would be our online dance challenge. It's going to be really, really big. We're dancing with women, hopefully thousands across the world. So that's our priority. And once we've launched that, the next is releasing our merch. Yeah.
Amazing. So, well, that means, you know what I have to do? I have to put in the calendar for next year to come back, and we have to do the whole fashion show and sportswear. And that's what we've got to check out.
Fashion show.
Yes. See, this is what ideas that just come in. They come in all the time. It is good. Well, ladies, Bemi and Eva, thank you so much. It was amazing to chat to you both, and good luck with everything. And I am going to come back and check in with you later on down the line, because as I said, you're such an inspiration. You've done such incredible things here, and it's always a pleasure for me to talk to you, because every time I speak to you, you've grown. This stuff gets better and better. This is what we need, and the UAE is fantastic for encouraging this sort of thing. So well done, and good luck.
Thank you so much, Emma. Thank you. Always a pleasure. Thank you. Thanks for having us.